Hey, fellow tech enthusiasts. Brandon here, and today, we're embarking on a deep dive into the fascinating realm of network penetration testing. Whether you're a seasoned cybersecurity pro or just getting started, understanding the nuances of network security is a journey worth taking. So, grab your virtual detective hats, and let's jump right in. Network penetration testing, also known as ethical hacking, is like having an X-ray vision for your network's vulnerabilities. In today's interconnected world, where our devices talk to each other, securing these connections is paramount. It's not about waiting for trouble, it's about actively seeking and shoring up potential weaknesses. Why bother with network penetration testing, you ask? Well, think of it as the proactive health check for your digital ecosystem. It's the Sherlock Holmes of the tech world, sniffing out vulnerabilities before they turn into security disasters. But how does it work? Let's break it down. Network penetration testing unfolds in three crucial phases, each unraveling a layer of your network's security fabric. Think of them as chapters in an evolving cybersecurity saga. First on our journey, pre-connection attacks. This is the reconnaissance phase, the digital equivalent of scouting the terrain before the battle. Imagine identifying potential vulnerabilities even before establishing a connection. It's not just about finding the weak spots, it's about understanding the landscape to craft a strategic approach. For instance, consider an attacker gathering information about a target network using techniques like footprinting and scanning. They could be identifying open ports, assessing the network structure, and pinpointing potential entry points. It's a silent dance in the shadows before the main act begins. Next up, gaining attacks. This is where we explore the art of cracking Wi-Fi keys and gaining unauthorized access to networks. Whether it's WEP, WPA, or WPA2, the goal is to understand and counteract the vulnerabilities in wireless networks. Picture yourself at a local cafe, sipping coffee, connected to their Wi-Fi. An attacker could exploit weaknesses in the network's encryption, gaining access to your device or intercepting your online activities. Gaining attacks equip us with the skills to prevent such intrusions and safeguard our digital interactions. Finally, we reach the post-connection attacks. You've breached the castle walls, so to speak. This phase is about powerful attacks that allow you to intercept connections, capture sensitive information, and even manipulate data in transit. Imagine being in a position to observe and modify the information flowing through the network. It's not just eavesdropping. It's a strategic game where you have the power to alter the course of data. These attacks are versatile, applying to both Wi-Fi and wired networks. Now, you might wonder, why ethical hacking? Ethical hackers, also known as white hat hackers, leverage the same tools and techniques as their malicious counterparts but with a crucial distinction, permission. Their mission is to strengthen security and fortify systems against potential threats. Consider a scenario where an ethical hacker identifies and patches a vulnerability in a financial institution's system before a malicious actor can exploit it. Ethical hacking is about staying ahead of the game, ensuring that the defenders are always one step ahead. As we wrap up this journey into network penetration testing, remember, this is merely the tip of the iceberg. In upcoming episodes, we'll delve even deeper into each subsection, exploring advanced techniques and real-world case studies. Stay tuned with us on Tech Sky for more in-depth explorations of cybersecurity, ethical hacking, and the ever-evolving world of technology. I'm Brandon, your guide in this digital adventure. If you enjoyed this exploration, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, like, and share. Until next time. Thanks for being part of this journey, and always remember, knowledge is your greatest defense in the digital realm.